بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This question comes from دكتورة إلهام. What is DART protocol? DART, D, dexamethasone in tiny babies. A, this is meta analysis. R, randomized. T, trial. So this is dexamethasone in tiny babies, meta analysis, randomized trial. If you will see here, this is when can consider DART protocol. This is systemic corticosteroid. Actually, it's controversial. There is two big meta-analysis. The first meta-analysis, early administration of the dexamethasone or systemic corticosteroid. And the early, this means less than 14 days after birth. After birth. And the late, this is or late administration of dexamethasone, it will be more than 3 weeks after birth. What is the difference between the early and late? The early, it will, based on the mortality and morbidity, the early, it will decrease the mortality and decrease the incidence of the BBD. The late will not decrease the mortality. Actually, it will decrease or reduce the chronic lung disease, but not increase the survival. And also, the early administration, it will be less than 14 days after birth. And the late, it will be more than 3 weeks after birth. And the early, it will give for decrease rate of the BBD, facilitate extubation, and also it will not affect on the length or the duration of hospitalization and oxygen use. But for the late, as we know, it should be severe chronic lung disease, established or evolving chronic lung disease. And the severe chronic lung disease, this means patient on ventilation or non-invasive or invasive, and oxygen required more than 30%, and should be, if actually the patient unsuccessful weaning from higher ventilation setting and oxygen support, and also respiratory status rapidly deteriorating. This is the late administration of dexamethasone. It will be more than 3 weeks after birth, and the patient on high mechanical ventilatory setting, high oxygen support, and there is respiratory status rapidly deteriorating. So shall now, this is indication, and there is indication to start the dexamethasone. And there is consideration to start the dexamethasone or systemic corticosteroid. And we said there's a lot of controversy about it. But what is the precaution before you start it? Before you start it, there is some precautions you have to take it before you start dexamethasone. It's not simple drug. Actually, it's not matter of resident decision. Even is not specialist decision, even is not senior doctor's decision. It's multidisciplinary approach, multidisciplinary decision, and should be actually should all consultant make it consensus to start the dexamethasone. It's not matter of resident decision or specialist decision. It's consultant decision, and even is not single consultant. Should be all consensus in the unit about to start the dexamethasone or systemic steroid. Why? Because actually a lot of adverse effect, and you have to counsel the parents because the poor neurodevelopmental outcome, this baby might be cerebral palsy, and actually the neurodevelopmental outcome or the long term outcome is still unpredictable. So you have to be cautious about use of the dexamethasone. So what is the contraindication or precaution to use it before you use dexamethasone? First of all, you have to know about the hypersensitivity of corticosteroid or dexamethasone, if there is hypersensitivity or no hypersensitivity. Second issues, you have to rule out there is late onset sepsis or sepsis. Is the baby is deteriorate or the baby critically ill, is not due to sepsis. You have to treat sepsis before you start dexamethasone. And also you have to detect this deterioration of the baby is not related to the BDA. You have to treat the BDA. Is not related to congenital infection or cytomegalovirus infection, because if you start dexamethasone and there is congenital infection or candidal infection, it it will flare the infection actually. If you started and there is hypersensitivity, it will have anaphylactic shock and the baby will die. So you have to take care about the precautions and contraindications before starting systemic corticosteroid or dexamethasone. You have to be sure is no hypersensitivity, and also you have to clear all the infections. Or even to be sure is no congenital infection, otherwise will flare the infection. No candidal infections, and also is BDA is treated, and you have to be sure is no GI bleeding or ulceration or renal disease. This is the most important factor here, the parent counsel and documentation. Before you start the dexamethasone, you have to parent consent after explanation of the potential benefit and risk of the treatment will be documented in the clinical notes, and you have to document it in the file. We discuss with the parent about the benefit for dexamethasone and what is the adverse effect of dexamethasone, and there is also the long-term neurodevelopmental outcome. This baby might lead to cerebral palsy. You have to counsel the parent before you start the dexamethasone, and after the counseling you have to document what you said and what you did with the parent regarding the counseling of the dexamethasone. Not written, not done. Not written, not done. What are dexamethasone regimen used in chronic lung disease? So which regimen I'm going to use it? Several regimen actually for use of dexamethasone in chronic lung disease has been described in literature. A lot of regimen, and they may be classified as short, it will be maybe 3 days, or intermediate, 7 days to 10 days, or long. You know, this dexamethasone was used before 42 days. Now, actually, at present, there are few comparative data recording the efficacy and safety of this regimen. The efficacy and safety of this regimen. This is one of the regimen, actually. This is DART protocol, 10 days protocol. We call it 3-3-2-2. 3 days, 3 days, then 2 days, 2 days. كأنك بتلعب ماتش كورة اللي هو 3-3-2-2. We'll see here. The first 3 days will start dose 0.075 milligram per kg per dose. 12 hourly BD. The frequency it will be BD. So this is the first 3 days will start dose 0.075 milligram per kg per dose, and another 3 days it will be half 25% reduction of this dose, it will be 0.050 milligram per kg per dose 12 hourly. Then for another 2 days it will be zero, half the dose, it will be 0.025 milligram per kg per dose 12 hourly, and the last 2 days it will be 0.01 milligram per kg per dose. So the protocol, it will be totally 10 days, 3 days it will be 0.75 milligram per kg per dose, then we're reduced by 25%, it will be 0.050 milligram per kg per dose, then we're reduced by another 25%, it will be or 50%, it will be 0.025 milligram per kg per dose, then until reach it to 0.1 milligram per kg per dose 12 hourly. If there is significant deterioration after tapering the dose on day 10, after you finish the protocol, the DART protocol 10 days, and the baby is still having significant deterioration, the patient is still not improved, what are going to do? Some individual may receive subsequent dose of 0.01 milligram per kg per day every 2 to 3 days. If the patient is not improved after the 10 days, you can actually subsequent, you can give the dose, or some individual may receive subsequent doses of 0.01 milligram per kg per day every 2 to 3 days. Actually, this is a individualization in the practice, depend on your unit, depend on your center. Then how when to repeat the course. Repeat the course may be indicated in selected infants with severe coronary lung disease. The patient given the protocol 10 days and patient improved for 1 week, then again deteriorate and require mechanical ventilation. Shall we repeat the course or no? Depend on your center. Again, depend on your selected case. Depend individualization. This individualization is not uniform. Actually, this may be indicated in selected infants with severe coronary lung disease. It's select. You have to select the patient. Individualize the practice. So what is the adverse effect and monitoring of during you are giving the corticosteroid? You have to monitor your patients. You have to monitor your patients. And what is the side effect of the corticosteroid? We said routine use of corticosteroid actually is discouraged by American Academy of Pediatrics and not be used to prevent or to treat BPD as routine use. Should be there is indication or consideration. So what is the adverse effect of the corticosteroid or dexamethasone or systemic corticosteroid? There is 4H, hyperglycemia, hypertension, and also hypertrophic cardiomyopathy if you are using it more than 1 week, and hemorrhage or GI bleed. Another 4B, poor neurodevelopmental outcome. It leads to cerebral palsy. And also poor long-term growth failure, bloodstream infection, and perforation. Especially if you are using it with indomethacin, it leads to spontaneous intestinal perforation. At the end, I would like to pray for my colleague going for the Saudi board, the Jordanian board, and Arab board, Egyptian board, and military fellowship. أسأل رب العرش العظيم أن ينجح كل زملائنا جميعا ومن أحيا فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. شكرا. سلام عليكم.